his head. He goes off and roll over that, and it's easy. It's a normal breakfall, just slightly. The minute I start to build stuff inside my head, the nervousness of what I think might happen, I start to either pull away from this, and my center disengages, which means I'm then in real trouble. I'll get the back, or I try and bring my other hand up because I think that's the one I can roll on. Look what it's done to my spine. It's straightened my spine up. I'm going to roll on it. I don't even like doing that to show people. That's not right. You watch babies roll, they never touch an angle. Kids rolling on the floor, it's always around them on the soft ones, you know. So you've got to trust in your ability to lift the shape, locate your centre, give it all of your attention. I mean, there's lots of other levels on this we could talk about to a blue in the face. Lots of ways to reinforce the fact that if my centre is pointed at what's important, that's directly concerning me at that moment in time, that I'm acting correctly. If I was talking to Hilda in a conversation, I'd like this. Yeah. It's bloody rude, isn't it? But I'm not giving her my full attention. I'm not being efficient. I'm not having a proper interaction with her. There's going to be no benefit for either of us. I'm not really giving my attention to everything that's going on. I'm not being authentic, and I'm not being efficient. I know that's kind of a tangent, but it's exactly the same as me taking a breakfall and someone putting coloured glass on and thinking, I've just let myself be thrown, I'll just let the centre meander over here like a satellite. It's no use. The minute I feel like, okay, my balance has been compromised, I engage everything with that. I'm aware of the person and what's going on, I'm picking up all the information I can. As this goes over, I've got this hand free, and I can do everything else. And there's all sorts of counters you can make then, because you're taking the balance break. The minute you start your Ukemi, even though your balance is gone, effectively you're taking your shape back. When this is out, I mean, tension angle is a classic separation technique. Head up, arm down, you know? If you're doing that and the other arm's coming up, you're basically putting the same disability on yourself. If you can withdraw that into one space, even if your balance goes, the minute you start doing that, you're back in a position of strength, even if you're in midair. Because the minute you land, you're effectively landing, you're not landing kind of like this. I'll be with you in a minute. Whatever the shape is, you're landing the back up and ready for round two. It's just common sense. So we'll try it again. What I want you to do now, I want to actually put a bit of movement on. You've had some fun with the shape. Actually put some movement on and take your partner's balance. Where's the next one? I know you can do this. So rather than me just taking him down, I'm actually going to step through his balance point. So do it across the mat so we don't get too many deaths. But take his hand to the floor. Okay? Take his hand right to the floor. So you can roll from contact, but I'm actually taking his balance. I'm not just giving him a vague, comfy guy, she's smelling the thing type of blame. Right, all the way through to, there's the balance, it's on the floor. There's no excuse then, because he's basically sitting his arm up. Have a go.